What happens if I don't update to Windows 11? Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here. Still not an AI for askleo.com. So staying with Windows 10, in other words, not updating to Windows 11, is a valid choice. I've written about how you can keep using Windows 10 safely after support ends. But there's more to it than that, isn't there? Over time, things are going to change. And it's important to understand what those things are and how you might need to prepare. Today, as I record this in November, actually, of 2025, the official end of support date for Windows 10 has passed. That means a couple things. It means that if a bug is found in Windows 10, you won't get a fix for it. If that bug is security related, in other words, if it actually exposes a vulnerability in the operating system, you won't get a fix for that either. And of course, official in-person help resources, to the extent they've ever been available, from Microsoft are no longer available. Although the documentation remains online and peer-to-peer support forums, of course, will continue to operate. And of course, extended security updates are available and they can stretch the support out for a year. So, let's take a look a year from now, October 2026. If you sign up for that ESU program, which you should still be able to do at any time, that end of support date kind of sort of changes to October 2026. Now, while there's been no official word on it, the ESU seems to have become a free program. As long as your computer settings are backed up to your Microsoft account, which appears to be the default. So there's really little reason for you not to sign up for it, other than the fact that, yeah, it requires you have a Microsoft account. This effectively gives you another year of most types of support. Now, after 2026, if a bug is found in Windows 10, again, you won't get a fix for it. If that bug is a security-related vulnerability, you won't get a fix for it. The only other thing is that I believe that this termination of the so-called in-person support, that didn't change. That still happened last month. All right. What else is going on? Well, today, at least one popular software package has announced that it will no longer support Windows 10. To quote, TurboTax Desktop 2025 will only run on Windows 11 64-bit. You won't be able to install or use TurboTax Desktop 2025 on Windows 10. So, alternatives for that one specifically include, well, not using TurboTax, or apparently switching to their online product. This is the only software I'm aware of now that has pulled Windows 10 support. It's really unusual in that it's an abnormally quick exit. Let's fast forward now to October 2028. Microsoft has promised that Windows Defender will continue to receive database updates for 3 years after the original Windows 10 end of support date. While they haven't said October 2028 specifically, that's the way the math works out. If Defender updates stop in 2028, and I suspect they may not, you'll need to switch to a different security package if you're still running Windows 10. Now, the reason I suspect that Defender updates may not end at that time is that we've been down this path before. Even though it was never promised, Microsoft continued to provide database updates for the equivalent Windows 7 tools for many, many years after that end of support date. I expect that a technical rather than a policy issue might drive the actual switch someday. By that I mean perhaps wanting to change something about the underlying security engine or its model beyond something that a simple database update would handle. And that could mean that they then have to end Defender updates. But for now, apps keep working. TurboTax aside, the apps you have installed in Windows 10 should keep working just fine. They're typically on their own update cycle. Those that use Windows Update should even continue to be updated. And of course, any tools that provide their own update mechanism will keep updating as well. For now. Eventually, yes, apps will drop Windows 10 support. Now, when I say eventually, I want to be clear. I mean over several years. Most apps will keep working just fine for a very, very long time. Then, slowly, and unfortunately, unpredictably, third-party apps may announce the end of support date of their own for running on Windows 10. If, when, and how you're affected depends on which apps you use and what those companies decide to do. Now, I claim that you really don't need to worry about this until you find out that you're affected. Like I said, it's probably going to be a while. Yep, some may pull a TurboTax and end support for Windows 10 early. But I expect that to be a very, very short list. Now, there is one thing that is going to be kind of ongoing. Throughout all of this, there's a really good chance that Microsoft will continue to encourage you to move past Windows 10. Depending on whether your machine is capable of running Windows 11, you may be offered the upgrade, which should be free, or you may be encouraged to purchase a new Windows 11-capable machine. You don't need to. Dismiss the messages and carry on. When they return, or if new ones appear, dismiss those as well. The bottom line here is that if you don't upgrade to Windows 11, there's really little to do other than take the steps you should already be doing to keep running Windows 10 safely. Someday, you may be affected when an application you use drops support for Windows 10. I wouldn't worry about it until that actually happens. It's likely, honestly, you'll have replaced your machine by then and be running the then current version of Windows, or maybe something else. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/186512. I'm Leo Notenboom, still not an AI. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.